Hello and welcome to The Big Picture. The criminal justice system in this country has been under scrutiny for several years. Though periodically the Law Commission and other bodies keep recommending measures to improve the system, the lacuna in its implementation continues. Both at the investigation and prosecution levels, several deliberate and not so deliberate attempts are always made to frustrate the justice system. One of the issues which is often found being discussed is the way in which cases related to politicians and other persons with power and authority or simply money are dealt with. Is there a uniform treatment in application of law and its interpretation is a question often asked. Recently, the rejection of the charge sheet filed by the Uttar Pradesh police against BJP President Amit Shah has raised some crucial questions about what are the laws and procedures relating to filing of charge sheet. We will discuss this today with K.N. Bhatt, senior advocate in the Supreme Court and former Additional Solicitor General of India, Shilpi Jain, advocate, Vivek Goyal, co-convener, legal cell of the BJP, and Justice B.A. Khan will be joining us very soon. Welcome to all of you. Mr. Bhatt, when we start talking of charge sheets being filed, what is the procedure? What is the basic procedure in the charge sheet? Is it section 173 which is the only thing? Yes. Or, you know?
The report under at the completion of the investigation.
Yes.
The investigating authority will file before the magistrate a report which is called as the charge sheet.
Yes.
And that particular charge sheet requires some formality. And in your introduction, you said that there are several mistakes, etc. You know, the lawmakers have anticipated mistakes. They expected many, at every level there will be some mistake, but nothing is fatal to the crime itself or the prosecution itself. There may be some delay, because very often in the present case, for example, what you mentioned, apparently what the magistrate has said that there are several documents and things like that are missing. And then, again, the newspaper report is not complete, on the basis of which what we say is that, look, 125 of the Representation of the People's Act itself is an offense. It creates an offense of somebody communal feelings, etc., etc.
Provoking the community, using
communal. So in the case of probably what I suspect is that the UP police have added this offense also in their charge sheet, and the magistrate said that the look, as far as the election commissions is concerned, did the election commission file? You can't file it, and that appears to be one of the objections. And other objections, I can't say what they are.
What has been reported is that the magistrate is telling the UP police that the police had not followed the provisions of 173.2 of the Criminal Procedure Code, since they did not try to arrest the accused before filing the charge sheet in court. See, this is the crucial element in this. Is there an absolute necessity that a person has to be arrested before the charge sheet is filed?
The answer is a big no. The arrest provision under Section 43 of the CRPC is only an enabling provision. 41 and 43 for the private citizen. It is an enabling provision. It is not a must. And, it is not that the moment a criminal case, a complaint or something is filed, somebody has to be arrested and kept under custody. That is not required at all.
So is the magistrate here...
If he is arrested, there is a column under 173.2.
Right.
Which says that, look, if so-and-so is arrested...
173.2e. It says whether the accused has been arrested. They just have to mention
maybe
it.
He said that no.
Either arrested or not arrested.
No, he has to say no.
Yes.
If he has been arrested, where is he, etc., particulars has to be given.
Right.
And in any case, nothing is fatal to the prosecution. And there is one more thing I wanted to know, that there is another news item about Adityanath.
Right.
And if anybody wants to have a lesson on how the prosecution is going to be start in beginning, they already started now against him. Identical provision, identical 153A and 295, etc., etc.
Right.
Same provisions have been invoked, and they are being tried, and except a little embarrassment and a little delay, I don't think that there is anything to even to make a headline in the newspaper.
So you don't think that the question raised by the magistrate in Muzaffarnagar?
It happens every other day. It happens. Magistrate finds fault with the police, whatever they do. They are all not reported because it happens.
It doesn't happen with the, you know, personalities involved.
The magistrate always says, look into it and give it back. This is every day.
Vivek Goyal, how do you look at it? You know, what is the problem here? You think the Muzaffarnagar magistrate was right in asking this question and rejecting the charge sheet? And we'll come to what happens once this charge sheet is rejected and what happens later. But do you think that the magistrate has done the right thing there?
No, that is the one aspect that you are looking at, that he has rejected. It also shows that how the police was filing this charge sheet.
Right.
They were in such a hurry that they...
I don't know what is the hurry, because this is a case which involves May 19, 2014, and now it's almost April, 6 months.
They were under such kind of pressure from their political bosses that they have to move against...
No, that is pure speculation, but you tell me what is the problem in the... You are
talking about the... If you talk the legality about the legality of this matter, India is having this legal system which is which was built pre-independence, and we are going through the same system after independence. So there are, as you said, that Law Commission has also given this whole process should be reform should be there.
Yes.
Even for police also, the Supreme Court has given that there should be police reform so that the victimization should not be there, especially in the political cases. There was another incidence where the Election Commission has given a notice to Mr. Azam Khan.
Right.
And on first instance, UP police had not... registered a FIR in that matter. So after Election Commission passed an order that UP police was directed to register a FIR, no action was being taken in. So in this matter, they were so proactive that they have not even completed the basic procedures.
So you think that the fault lies with the police and because they were in a hurry and they have done this. Otherwise, you don't find any fault.
This is the...
Okay. Shilpi, how do you look at this? You know, you have been handling several cases, not just, all over the country about in these kind of matters. Is this common, what happens? Or, do you see these kind of things happening only in certain cases?
No, I'm not sure what the order was, because from what you say,
yes,
it's not clear whether the magistrate actually took cognizance. Charge sheets are returned, and yes, there are certain common cases when charge sheets are returned. And those cases are where either sanction is required for prosecuting a particular person, or there is lack of jurisdiction. Such glaring things are there when charge sheets are returned. Or at precognizance stage, the magistrate can order further investigation.
Sorry, Shilpi, all three which you mentioned doesn't apply in this case. I'll just read out so that you get some clarity.
Yes. So I'm just telling you, normally... those are the circumstances where charge sheets are returned.
Okay.
In this case, what you tell me that because there were no arrests,
yes,
this will be a bizarre interpretation and a wrong interpretation of law, and this will become another example of a case where, in case because it deals with a powerful man, we have a bizarre and wrong interpretation of law, because here the person concerned, the accused, is a very powerful man, so they interpret law according to their own convenience. There is no requirement in hundreds of cases, especially those of CBI. The court summons them subsequently after the charge sheet is filed. They appear in the court, and they may be arrested on the very first date, or if they file the bail at that time, they may be granted bail. So there is no precondition that the person must be arrested. It's entirely the discretion of the police. So it's also, I think it's both the police deliberately filing a smudged report in this case, and also the magistrate deliberately giving a smudged order, because both the things appear to be very bizarre.
That is interesting. Justice Khan, there is some problem with the video with him, but we have him on the audio line, I think. Justice Khan.
Yes.
You know, what is the precondition for filing a charge sheet? Is there a precondition to arrest, that a person needs to be arrested before filing a charge sheet?
No, I don't think that can be a precondition. In case the charge sheet is in order in other respects, though magistrate has a competence and a power to refuse to take cognizance or to return the charge sheet, as Shilpi was saying, in certain cases on certain grounds. But in this case, I don't know what are the reasons for which the magistrate returned. And if those reasons do not hold good, nothing prevents the investigating agency to seek a remedy against that return. Unless it is politically expedient to both sides to treat it this way and to say goodbye to the whole thing.
Justice Khan, there is also, the report also says that the court returned the charge sheet to remove the errors. Whatever errors they have found, those errors, whatever those errors, is not very clear. It said the police cannot file a charge sheet under section 188 of IPC, as it should be filed as a private complaint by the officer concerned who has imposed prohibitory orders which were violated. Now, what is this bringing the... I'll come to you, Mr. Bhatt, also on this.
This magistrate got this from where, but in case in his wisdom it makes some sense, then police must get it scrutinized from their legal circles and see whether it is sustainable at all. But offhand, I will not be able to say whether the view taken by a magistrate is good or bad.
But
supplement Justice Khan on the... See, there are apparently two sets of allegations against Mr. Amit Shah. One is under the Indian Penal Code,
right?
153A, 295A, 505, etc. And these, of course, they all are cognizable offences, and police have registered FIR, and they can take it.
These are under Representation of People Act and IPC, or only IPC?
No. These are only IPC.
Okay.
Under Representation of People's Act, Section 125, also. In substance, it is the same offence as 153A, one of the parts.
This is related to, you know,
provoking the religion. But this applies only during the election.
Right.
125. Whereas the Indian Penal Code is 24 hours, 365 days.
Right.
All the time it is applicable. So there the police are entitled to go and they are authorized to go and give a complaint. Whereas from the newspaper report, at least what I feel is that court said that how can you add this 125 in your charge sheet? Probably that is added.
Was the police right in doing it, or they should
they
not
did
have...
it, if they did it, apparently they are wrong.
Okay.
Because, you know, because if the 125, if there is a prosecution, an election commission's representative, somebody can make the court, but maybe a private complaint. But there is no problem about the rest of the items. Rest of the three items are definitely police alone have to do it.
Under the IPC?
Under the IPC.
So they should not have included this. Vivek Goyal, do you have a clear idea of what has happened? In any case, Girish,
what I am telling you, this one is a very technical thing has been. This can be repaired and corrected and rectified and submitted tomorrow or day after.
No, but that doesn't mean that the person needs to be arrested before this. That is not necessary. Do you have a clear idea of what the case was against Mr. Amit Shah and what has been the order? You don't have a clear thing about it?
No, that is a different issue entirely. What was the case? Now we here.
What was the case? According to you, what was the case?
No, we can't go into the merit of the issue.
No, we are not going to the merit.
We are on the procedure right now. So the procedure, if you go into the history of this whole procedure, which is there, it is this whole system, as I was saying, is called adversarial legal system. This was developed during the British East India Company. And it continued during the British period, and it is continuing afterwards. So Law Commission has also given a report that adversarial legal system should be changed. In adversarial legal system, the procedures are really complicated, and many judges could not understand, many police officers could not understand. So they fell prey to this kind of procedural flaws.
So you think there was only a procedural flaws here?
This is a procedural flaw.
This is a procedural flaw. This was not a deliberate flaw.
This is a procedural flaw by the police, because they were in such a hurry and under pressure.
But do you think that it's just a procedural flaw?
I think to commit an error like this, police don't have to have any motive. Without any motive, they are capable of committing any number of this error. The number one election offense under the police vocabulary, it is one of the very low priority items. It is not a rape or a murder or something like that, in which case that is something which the police try to...
They'll be under pressure also.
Pressure also. And this is a very... Election Commission has given a complaint, register FIR. So they registered FIR, and after registering FIR, it has to go to the magistrate. They sent it to the magistrate. While going there are several errors according to the newspaper report. And tomorrow when they correct these errors, and just go and present it again, and then the slow process will start.
Right. The only problem here is, if it's a simple case of correcting the errors, as you know, some of the newspapers indicate, and some of my panelists here also saying, then there should be no problem. But the problem lies when the magistrate comes out with this statement that, you know, why have you not arrested? Why have you come to me before arrest? And also this question of what Mr. Butt was talking about, you know, including the sections under the Representation of People Act along with this. And when the magistrate says that, you know, you cannot file a charge sheet under Section 188 of IPC, all this gets a little muddled up.
You know, I think from what you are telling me, I don't know the background at all, but from what you are telling me, what I see is it's not only the police that has done very shoddy investigation and the procedures have been obviously messed up. It's the magistrate also who needs to read up some law and or is deliberately, you know, looking the other way. Because if there are errors in the charge sheet, there is no reason for the magistrate to ask the police to rectify them. The magistrate is fully empowered to completely throw aside the charge sheet and take a re-look at it and take cognizance of offences which the magistrate thinks are made out based on the evidence before it. And at the stage of charge, again, there is a stage before the court where the charges will be framed only as per the sections which the evidence makes out. There is all the power with the court. The court cannot, at this stage, after taking cognizance, ask the police to reinvestigate. There, the law is clear. What the magistrate has done, it has messed up the law even further. What the police did was a big mess. But at this stage, it was required of the magistrate to at least, clean up what the police had done. And it is fully empowered to clean up. It can take cognizance only of those offences, that this is the evidence, I take cognizance, and I've read the file, this is the evidence, these are the offences made out. And charges, later at the stage of charges are made out under these sections. You don't need the police officer to tell the magistrate what are the sections made out.
Okay.
So it's now the magistrate, it's in the court of the magistrate to say that these are the offences, and magistrate cannot at this stage, after taking cognizance, ask the police to reinvestigate or to, it's the power of the police. Police can get more documents, add witnesses. The magistrate under law has no power to ask the police either to add documents or to relook into the case or to reinvestigate. So it's the magistrate who is more either deliberately unaware of the law seriously unaware of the law or deliberately looking the other way.
Okay.
But this is not the procedure at all, legally.
Okay. That's
if there is a mess up by the police, it's for the magistrate to clean up.
Okay. Justice Khan, would you agree with that, what Shilpi is saying?
Yeah, what Shilpi is saying is the correct position in law. See, this magistrate appears to have gone in panic, perhaps looking at the name of the accused. The only course which is normally open to a magistrate is after the charge sheet is presented to him with whatever investigating material, he has to take cognizance or not to take cognizance, depending upon whether an offense is made out or not. It does not normally, is not none of his usual businesses to tell police that you have not done this, you have not done that, you have not done that. Now, what he ought to have done, if he had proceeded legally, was that if a case was, some kind of a case was made on the investigating report, he should have taken cognizance of that kind, that limited extent to the of that offense. If something was not made out, he should have refused taking cognizance, for which he has to pass an order. And in case he passes an order, he has to give some reason. And if this, that reason is good and bad, and then a person has a remedy against that. But this seems to be a novel procedure adopted on all sides. I don't know more because of expediency. But in any case, the normal procedure has been given a go by, it seems so.
Okay.
And for what reason, one doesn't know.
Okay. Mr. Bhatt, yeah. You know, the larger issue. Do you think that there is now need, you know, with these kind of confusions happening? Is this something which could be corrected, as you know, Goyal was talking about? Is there an attempt at the higher level, to simplify the procedures, make it more uniform? Because you know, each magistrate interpreting these kind of things in different way, is this unavoidable?
See, the need for amendment and changes is a continuous process. In the law, there is a continuous process that you may have to do it. But I don't think that this case has thrown out anything, any greater need or an immediate, because number one, of course, I am very slow to make any allegation against a judge or a magistrate. Because I don't.
Give him the benefit of. You want to give him the benefit of doubt?
Not benefit of doubt. I am too experienced to make that one. Because in over 50 years in the bar, I don't think that it is something which can be easily. It is not a first resort. And number two, in the process of this one, I, with very respectfully, I don't know whether Justice Khan has said that he did not have the full material, maybe the reason, and even I don't have the full material. But whatever material is there, if this were not to be the case of Mr. Amit Shah, this would not have come to the newspapers.
This would not have come to anybody's notice.
Because, you know, this type of
thing. No, but you know, it is only when such cases come up, when such high profile cases come up, we also get an opportunity to discuss these kind of
things. That's fine. That's okay. That's fine. But there is nothing great point of law or in this aspect. Criminal procedure as such may require a lot of changes. Quite a few have been suggested by Mallimatt Committee and very several other committees, including Law Commission. All those things have been pending. That is a different thing.
Why has it been pending? Why do you think that, you know, there is no hurry. There is no seriousness in tackling this problem.
See, the reason is one of the things. For example, the benefit of doubt, whether that should be the sole ground on which a defense lawyer wins or not. This was debated by Mallimatt Committee and the Law Commission also, and said that there should be some little more than simply creating it. Accused can't sit quietly and say that, look, you prove it. One little doubt is good enough for me to get an acquittal. The whole body of lawyers opposed this particular thing, because in the today criminal law practice in India, major item is to create a doubt. Create a doubt, because, you know, this one, I'll say that police diary page number so-and-so is missing, and how it is missing, the lawyer knows, but not the prosecution. So, because the reform is very difficult. Reform.
The resistance, because the resistance.
Resistance.
Okay. I think Mr. Justice Khan wants. Yes, Justice Khan?
Yeah, Girish, we have been grappling with this problem of reform over the decades. And we have not been able to make any headway. And for that, there are so many factors and reasons. And essentially, we don't have a will at reform. You know, if some, even if parliament goes for a reform, that the lawyer community will oppose it. You have a number of reports, as Mr. Bhatt was saying, Malimart and Menon report and Law Commission report and all that. But over the years, we have not been able to make any reform as such, which can, for example, you have to start with the police reform first. And right. We have a Supreme Court judgment on the police reform, which is languishing somewhere.
Absolutely.
Similarly, after that, you have to have the reforms at the second stage, that is court restructuring. Then you have to have a reform at the prosecution agency stage. Unless you have an independent prosecution agency, unless you have an independent investigating agency, unless you have an efficient court system, how can you achieve a result? And unless you have a reform in these procedural bogus laws, which do not ultimately culminate in any kind of a justice,
okay,
where you don't get any conviction rate at all, then where do we go?
Okay. So
the whole thing seems to be in a mess, and there is no one to clear it. And these are only slogans which these people are making at the time of need, that for a political class, we will have a trial in 1 year. We have 2 crores of criminal cases pending in the courts in this country. How come you are segregating 153 people for a special treatment in those courts, unless you create a special class of courts for trying politicians only?
Okay.
So this is a problem which is so much confronting us, and it has been confronting us all these years.
Okay.
And I don't see any light at the end of the tunnel. Anyway, Girish, I am a disappointed man on
I hope you don't need to be so pessimistic. Maybe there is some optimism there. Vivek Goyal, you think that your party is in power now. You know, you are the co-convener of BJP cell. Is there any discussions in your cell at the party level, at the higher level, that, you know, to bring about some reforms in this? Mm-hmm. And can we see some hope, and people like Justice Khan need not be so disappointed?
No, we are discussing this issue for a long. When NDA was in power from 1999 to 2004, Justice Malipanth Committee was appointed. And it discussed this whole issue in detail. The problem of adversarial legal system is common. It is not just in India this problem is there. It is in all common law countries.
No, but you know,
this
you
kind of flaws are there.
You think that there is some, at least at the party level, there is some
attempts
being made.
Attempts are being
and
made.
And the government level also.
Government has appointed this committee, and it has given
now
its recommendation.
The onus is on the, because it was your own government which had appointed. Very quickly,
I may add, Mr. Arun Jaitley, the law minister, introduced quite a few changes to be made on the basis of Malimut committee.
Right.
Only a few could pass, and thereafter the government changed.
Right.
And
so now it is time for them to
hopefully
revisit the Malimut committee and complete the task which they are undertaking. Shilpi, would you like to add anything very quickly?
You know, I think inefficient investigation agencies and a weak prosecution is always in the interest of politicians for reasons we all know. So it's serving their own interest that they don't want to strengthen these two agencies, because otherwise it's not so difficult to reform both the systems.
Okay, I think on that note we need to end. There is despair, there is hope. Both despair and hope, we will wait and see which will prevail over the next few days, but the next few months and years. But as far as the specific case is concerned, we'll have to wait and watch when the corrected charge sheet is filed, how the magistrate and how the magistrate will look at it, and what turn the case will take. Thanks to all my guests, Justice Khan, K.N. Bhatt, Vivek Goyal and Shilpi Jain. Please keep watching. We'll come back with another issue in Big Picture, same time on Monday. Meanwhile, have a great weekend.